Measurement Unit Section 1, Measurement Conversion Technique. We're going to develop one technique that will allow us to convert within the English system, metric system, or English to metric, and vice versa. It's based on taking the measurement, multiplying by 1 to give us an equivalent value. Most of us are familiar with the fact that if we take a number, multiply it by 1, we get that number back. Well, we're going to replace that 1 with an equivalent value of 1. And here's an illustration or an example. By taking 4 over 4, 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. We're still multiplying by 1. No surprise that we would get 3 feet. But if we're multiplying by a fraction, it's easier if everything looks like a fraction. So we're going to replace 3 feet with 3 feet over 1. It's understood that any number has a denominator of 1. And the rule for multiplying fractions together is to multiply the numerators together. So we will have 3 times 4, resulting in 12 feet in the numerator. And then multiplying the denominators, 1 times 4 gives us 4. If we would simplify this fraction, we would be back to the equivalent 3 feet that we had. But if we want to convert our 3 feet into, say, inches, and we know that there are 12 inches in 1 foot, we can arrange those equivalent values, 12 inches and 1 feet, into a fraction similar to the 4 over 4, which is equal to 1. 12 inches, since it's equal to 1 foot, this results in a value of 1. It's called a conversion factor fraction, which is equal to 1. Now, we could have put 1 foot over 12 inches, but you're going to see in a minute that any time we have a common value in the numerator and the denominator, we can cancel them out. And by having the 1 foot factor in the denominator, it's leaving us with inches in the numerator, which is going to take our original feet measurement and convert it into inches. Now go ahead with the multiplication of these two fractions. We have 3 times 12 inches in the numerator and 1 times 1 in the denominator. Simplifying, we end up with 36 inches over 1, an equivalent value for the 3 feet, or just 36 inches. In another example, we have 1,000 cubic inches and are asked to determine an equivalent gallon quantity. So same procedure and steps that we just went through. The first thing we want to do is to take the given information and express it as a fraction, which means we're going to put a denominator of 1 on that. Next, we want to find a conversion factor that deals with cubic inches and gallons. And we want that cubic inches in the numerator to cancel out in the denominator. So we know right now on our conversion factor that hopefully ties these two quantities together that the cubic inches must be expressed in the denominator. So on your conversion table in your book on page 38, under the first column, the English measurement, and on the bottom half of that first column under liquid measurement, we identify that there are 231 cubic inches equal to 1 gallon. This will be the 2 conversion factors that we will use that will help us convert our cubic inches into gallons. We've already decided that for this arrangement, we will have the cubic inches in the denominator and the 1 gallon in the numerator. Since these two values are equivalent, this fraction is equal to 1, so we're multiplying our 1,000 cubic inches by a special 1, which will give us an equivalent value and hopefully the unit and answer that we're looking for. So as we multiply, anytime there's something common in the numerator and denominator, we cancel it out. Fraction multiplication, we'll multiply the numerator values together and the denominator values. Multiplying by 1 doesn't change the values, so this simplifies to 1,000 gallons over 231. And the last step is to take the numerator divided by the denominator, giving us an equivalent value to the original 1,000 cubic inches is a 4.3 gallons.